Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel. I hope you all alright and sound having nice day. Of course, we gathered here to do some PlayStation VR news. We're gonna talk about the Elysia, we're gonna talk about Crisis Brigade Co-op, but also release window for Vacation Simulator Back to Work DLC and some other updates for some other games, which of course are for totally nothing, which is nice. Okay, so let's just jump into it and let's start from the Elysia, a very nice upcoming RPG, people getting excited for it. Earlier on this week, I just let you know that the Kickstarter is coming up on 4th, and today the Kickstarter started, so I'm gonna put link in the description. Looks like the Kickstarter is a very big success because they already got like over a quarter of a funds they asked for, and that's not even been up for a day, so it looks like this game gonna be successful, looks like it will happen. Sadly, not the same story as with the Distortion VR, the game I was looking forward to, but this one sadly didn't have a very successful Kickstarter. Nevertheless, I'm hearing the developer still will make it, might just take a bit longer, maybe it's gonna be smaller game, I don't know. But Elysia looks very good. I'm gonna showcase very nice trailer tomorrow in my PSVR showcase. But today I can tell you that I already had a chance like to be inside the game, into this world of the game. Everything what I saw looked very promising, the map was large, the buildings looks nice, the activities that the developer explained to me sounded very interesting. So if you want some online RPG action that is actually going to happen, then you can go to Kickstarter and support the developers from there. Best of luck to them. I'm hoping this Kickstarter gonna be super successful and we're gonna see this game as soon as possible. Okay, anyway, moving on to the next story, and now it's time to talk about Crisis Brigade 2, a game that I really like, just like with the first one, but it's even better than first one, so I like it even more. But what first game does, it's got co-op. Last year it's got this co-op update and it's made this game so much better. And this year the developers already announced when the game released that the co-op update's gonna come this summer. I don't know where you live, but here in England the summer I think ended now, I suppose. So what's happening with this game now, it's just around the corner, basically the co-op update. They already said they've been testing it, now they're saying they're testing the second mission, this Montoya mission. So they like more than halfway through, they just gonna have to do third mission in co-op. And then we finally gonna get it, so I'm expecting it late September, early October, and we should have it. And this update of course will be for totally free. So if you bought the game, you just go and update it and then you can invite your friends or play with randoms and enjoy this game that way. It's such a fun experience, and the first one with co-op, it's not only very fun, but also there is some hilarious moments watching people dying straight away. So you know what, it's well worth picking this game up now and then you're gonna have even more content. I don't know if they're gonna add any more new missions like in the first one, but I do hope they're gonna release some more Crisis Brigade games, because this game, you know what, it's got something. There's something there what keeps players attracted. It's not the biggest game, it's not the massive game, but it's one of the most enjoyable on PlayStation VR. And I must say the step from the first one to the second one was quite big, especially when it comes to graphics, but also they made gameplay more hectic, but also more rewarding because now you can unlock stuff and buy stuff and just do things like that. Anyway, that's about it about Crisis Brigade, but we're gonna still talk about updates. Anyone remember Viking Days? Anyone of you ever bought this game? I don't know, it's been out for a while now, is it like 2 years or so? I don't know. But this is a game which basically lets you become a Viking and do 6 of various Vikings activities. But if you're thinking like, okay, I've done all of that, what else I can do? And the developer announced today, to my surprise, that they bring in brand new update which gonna add even more activities, brand new 6 activities. So if you got Viking Days and maybe perhaps you even forgotten about this game, then you'll be reminded very soon because the update will be with you very soon as well, so that's nice to see. This is coming from the studio that working on this upcoming Kart Racer at the moment. In past they released Apocalypse Rider and the Rabbit Hole, but definitely Viking Days was probably their best game up to date. But this little Kart Racer looks pretty cool as well, so anyway, Once I know release date for this update, I let you know, but it's probably gonna be soon, I'm assuming. And speaking about update and free stuff and free DLC, we still gonna talk about it. Time to talk about Vacation Simulator Back to Work DLC. So this actually releases next week for PC and Quest players, I think. And PlayStation VR owners gonna get it next month in October, so just 1 month longer. And this of course is for totally free as well, so if you own Job Simulator, you just update your game and there you go, you can play it. What they did now is they saying, okay, you've been on vacation, you all relaxed and rested, now it's time to get back to work, just like the title says. So what you doing, you swap in your way, your roles with the machines, with robots. In the Vacation Simulators, robots been serving you, now you be serving them. And of course they gonna expect you to do, give them 5-star treatment, so you gonna be have to pretty good at what you're doing. So kind of Job Simulator, you know, like this game going back to its roots, like Job Simulator, but new activities and stuff, which is nice. Job Simulator still one of the most popular VR games and also PSVR games. Vacation Simulator very popular as well, so if you are a fan of this series, very soon you're gonna get tons of new content and you'll be able to hop back in and enjoy it. Okay, and now I want to talk a bit about Stride. So it's still not known if it's gonna be on PS4 or on PS5 when it comes to VR, but the developers said basically we're doing PC version first. Once it exits Early Access, then PSVR owners gonna get it. It's actually released today in Early Access. Only the endless mode, and then they gonna add story mode and everything, and then you'll be having your full release, and then they will work on PSVR version. But also that's not the thing I want to talk about. What I want to talk about is the Oculus Quest version actually, and how it might translate to PlayStation VR version. Because what the developers saying, they might not be able to do story mode on the Quest, but what they gonna do instead is make this game multiplayer, which is something what I actually looking forward to more than playing story mode. So I'm kind of hoping maybe we gonna get the multiplayer and story, you know, best of both. I don't know how the multiplayer will work, I don't know yet, they working it out, but I'm assuming you could have like this competitive gameplay, like races maybe, you know, your free running parkour style races. Maybe they will have player versus player, who knows, they got those shooting mechanics in this game as well. But nevertheless, I just wanted to let you know that when the game releases, we might actually get more than what we expected. And Stride of course captured imagination of many players because of how Mirror Edge-esque this game is. It's kind of very inspired by it. They changed the art style a bit, probably to distinguish two games a bit more, unless they're gonna do this Mirror Edge style in the story mode, I don't know. But as of now, I've got this game on PC, still didn't have time to play it, but of course I do watch YouTube, I do watch reviews, and people are kind of very kind of this, on this game. A lot of players liking it, very good concept, of course free running in VR, it's got to feel good. I'm assuming if you like the games like To The Top and Sprint Vector, that's the best example I can think of, then think about combining them both and adding a bit of shooting mechanics as well. I'm hoping they're gonna add bullet time, because bullet time in VR, we know it feels very good. But as of now, from what they did, it looks like we up for a treat when it releases eventually. But like I said, sadly it might be a while away, the PSVR port, and it even might be on PlayStation 5, we don't know. Also they working on another PSVR game, which probably gonna be there before Stride, and this is Time Hacker, which I did preview of. This was kind of original take on the virtual reality game, because you like manipulating time, you stop in time, but you can manipulate all the objects, it's all physics based. They got scenes like from superhero movies, it's pretty awesome, so that's a cool game as well. So this studio releasing some bangers, so I cannot wait till they come to PlayStation VR. But anyway, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.